We're sanding and we're painting today. It's gonna be a great day. The sun is out. I got my orange outfit on. And we're gonna be painting. This is gonna be fun, guys. As fun as painting can be. What can I say? It's painting. So we got the holes patched up. And if you haven't seen that video, it's on the video somewhere down there that I did yesterday. I'll post that on there. And today we're gonna be sanding down the spackle that we did and then giving it a nice coat of paint to go over everything. And that way it looks like almost a brand new wall, but a lot of brackets sticking out of it. And it's ready for our shelves to be put on as soon as we find the wood to do. Let me look up here, yay. I was looking at the camera, which was me, and yeah, kind of forgot to look at you guys. Just put it right there in the middle. Anyway, so we're gonna be painting today, and we got our sweet jams going on. This is some Hall & Oates. Yeah, I love it. Have you ever seen 60 Days of Summer? And he does the dance, and everybody's doing like, I wanna be part of that, that's my world that I want to live in, is where everybody just breaks out in a spontaneous dance with little birds floating on their hands. That would be amazing. Okay, so I'm gonna get my paint set up. I have my sandpaper, I have a little sponge. I was trying to find the mask that my mom made because she made a ton of really great, cute masks that went around your head instead of around your ear, because I don't want to take off my little bandana. I got it going on my head right now, and I like it. I could take it off, but you know, I'll just put on another bandana. You can never have too many bandanas. Yay, so many fun colors, so many fun ideas to choose from. So I'm gonna put on my little bandana, and then we're gonna start sanding down. And as usual, I'm gonna do it in fast motion because everything's better in fast motion. So let's get started. It's a nice solution if you don't have like a little sander, because I just went to the hardware store, but I didn't need to get one because I already knew I had this little sponge and a little piece of sandpaper. So I'm just gonna be using this to do it.
I fell asleep beneath the flowers.
I fell asleep beneath the flowers.
For a couple of hours.
For a couple of hours.
So one thing I should note too, yesterday, and if you saw the video, what we did is use painter's tape to patch the little holes that were covering up the brackets, and then we used the spackling paste to cover that tape. So when I'm sanding it down, I'm not trying to go really hard against the wall. I just want to give it a light sand. I don't want to scrub off any of that tape that we put on. So I'm just kind of going around the edges softly and then around the tape softly, just to make sure that it's kind of smoothed out and you don't see the lines of the tape. So not too hard. We're not trying to sand off the drywall. We're just trying to get the light coat going on.
But not too loud, cause the baby's sleeping. I wonder if it knows what the world is keeping. Up both sleeves while you lay there dreaming. Me and my bro.
Okay, yay! So that's done. And I did not peel any tape off the wall doing that, which was the main goal of trying to do it softly, because I don't want to peel off the tape and then have to retape and then replaster, then wait for it to dry and go through that whole process. So I just wanted to do a light sanding over, and that's it. And then we're gonna get a wet wipe and wipe down the wall so we get all that dust off of there and get to our painting job. I love Katy Perry and the song. This is not just on my roller skating playlist, it's on my Divine Feminine playlist, because this song is awesome. Thank you, Katy Perry. I love it. I love belting this song out in the car. Good, pump it up song. And you're gonna hear me roar. Walls cleaned up, sanded, cleaned, vacuumed, ready to get painted. I want to start with a clean surface as much as possible because I don't want any of that dust getting into our money paint. This paint is infused with money oils and we've done some blessings on it. We put some money juju into it. We don't need any of that old dust getting into that awesome, awesome energy of the money paint we got going on. So I want to clean my surface very well and then go from there. I could have stayed at home because I was always better alone. Unrolling the rollers. It's like paint roller show. Okay, I'm gonna turn down to a... I love that song. Okay, so let me just show you here. I always say so while I'm moving the computer. I'm learning. I'm not used to filming, so let me get out of that shadow and see if we're doing it this way instead. Yeah, I think the older I get, the less afraid I am to say that I don't know everything. And I'm still learning. I'm learning every day new things. And I like it. So I am not ashamed to say I am learning something new. In fact, I love learning something new. So we're going to do our paint, but I'm gonna move you over here where you can actually see this. It gets kind of loud when I set down the computer and I'm picking up and putting down the computer when I need to because it just doesn't show up on my phone well. And I apologize for all the little bangs and nicks and all that stuff. When I have better equipment, it will sound better than right now. I have my computer, which is awesome for what I need to do, and I love the gift. So, that being said, a while ago, I'm going to pause this because it's distracting me now. A couple days ago, let me sit down here. Yeah. So a couple days ago, we did the essential oils for money manifestation into our paint that we have. And so the paint that we're using is by Sherwin-Williams, and this is their cashmere paint. And what the cashmere is known for, apparently, is self-leveling. And this is the paint that we've used on the wall. This color that I'm using is called jadeite, which is something that Cam helped pick out based on the energy that he was feeling when he looked at all the other different greens. He wanted green in this space to draw in money magic. Because this is his home office and you want to be doing some good business here and bringing in the deals and bringing in the money. If you're working, don't you want to get paid for that? So yes, bring in the money, money magic. And everything is energy, everything. So you can infuse your paint with the different essential oils based on the mood that you want to feel, what you're wanting to bring into your life, what you want to manifest, all those things, infuse it into the wall because the space that you're in is energy as well. You can feel that when you go into an older place and you can feel the energy of the last person that was living there. So in this space, we wanted to start off with something new and fresh. This is a new building, which is awesome. He just bought this place back in March of last year, I believe. And this room used to be the bedroom, like a little guest bedroom, which just didn't feel like a guest bedroom. And it's downstairs on the first level. There's four levels to this place. So this room, it has one window. I didn't want to go too dark. So picking a green, you know, with a green tone, I didn't want to do the wrong type of green because some greens can just make you sick. And you want to sit in the feeling of what that color makes you feel. And if you do color therapy, which I do, just running through the colors, and if it doesn't feel right, you don't want to have it wrapped around you. You don't want to be in that. And then every day you're kind of in this like I feel kind of sick and I feel off and I feel low vibration. So we wanted to put some good energy into this paint, and I love the color of it. I really do love the color a lot. So I'm excited to see once everything's put in here. But we're dealing with one window, two overhead lights. I'm getting different different lights for the desk and around the area. So hopefully when everything's done, it's not gonna be crazy dark in here. It will be some good energy. And this paint can bring in some happy, happy money. There's a book by Ken Honda called Happy Money. And I came across Ken on a YouTube episode on Inspire Nation, which I follow, and I love Michael Sandler and all of his guests on there. So thank you for all of the work that you do. But I came across Ken Honda, and he talks about happy money. Happy money. What's your IQ and your EQ, your emotional attachment to money? And the energy that you bring in, I love money, money loves me. Bring that energy into whatever room you're wanting to manifest the most money. And you can bless the paint. That might sound a little cuckoo to you, but that's not something I subscribe to, so I do the thing that I need to do. So I'm gonna infuse the paint with a lot of loving money, money energy. And I am calling in all of the archangels to just help with this loving money energy coming into the space. So we've already painted all of this room. I'm not gonna paint all the other walls. I'm just gonna paint this focus wall that we did the shelving on, that we're doing the shelving on. And it won't take that long, but I wanna re-stir this paint because it's been sitting for a while. I've had those oils in here for a while. And again, this color is jadeite. If you like this color, it's by Sherwin-Williams. And I think this gallon cost about $45. I don't really shop at Sherwin-Williams that often. I'm used to doing Home Depot a lot and Lowe's. They have the Valspar, then the Bear. And I haven't really ventured over to Sherwin-Williams much, but I do like them and I like the colors and they color match and all that good stuff. So maybe that will be kind of my new thing. I'm gonna get this little money brew stirred up in here. Make sure all the mojo is coming up to the surface. Now I'm actually going to add in a couple more drops of the oil that we have as well. Okay. So I have my lovely prosperity oil. And this is something that I got at Z Fabrique in Long Beach. I love their little shop. And I like getting my oils from there. And crystals, they have a lot of great crystals if you're into crystals, which I totally am. Okay, so we're gonna put some prosperity oil in there. I'll just tilt this down a little bit more. And it makes your paint smell nice too. If you don't like the smell of your paint, you can actually add things into it to make it smell a little bit better. And my motto is, why not an essential oil that also brings in some good energy? I know they have some like artificial flavors and fragrances and all that other stuff. But you can also mix in some nice lavender in your bedroom, maybe, if you want to get comfortable and go to sleep. Some love oils, some sensual oils. This is my King Midas essential oil. And this is from Points of Light in Long Beach. I've only gone there a couple times. My sister orders a lot of stuff from there, like a lot of her oils. She's an apothecary. So it's called Points of Light. It's in Long Beach. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for all of this loving money, magic mojo going into this paint. Thank you, thank you, thank you. so it is. And so it is. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Money Magic. For all the wealth and abundance. I see large sums of money flowing easily and effortlessly to this space, to this person. To this painter, to this worker, to this world, large sums of money flow easily and effortlessly that you can spend on whatever you want, have to share, have to keep, have to spend, have to play, have to enjoy, have to travel, have for luxuries, for self-care, for paying all the bills, plus everything that you ever need. Large sums of money. Already feel that money juju, that beautiful money juju. Oh, so pretty. I love this color. Jadeite. I'll have to remember this. So, we have our paint blessed, we have our paint infused with our money oils, and now we just need to put our paint up on the wall, and we'll be done with this wall until our shelves get in, and then it's all about the decorating and all the other fun stuff. But right now we're going to be painting the last coat on the wall. If you've never tried blessing your paint, give it a try. See how you feel. What can it hurt? Infuse your energy into it. You are a crystal. You are an energy being. You can infuse all the things you want into the space that you have. Make it a beautiful space, a space that you feel amazing in. You can have all of that energy go to how you want the space to make you feel. All the cozy, all the warm, all the money, all the love, all the stuff. You have that power. So now that that's said, let's turn back on the music and get this painting party started. This is like my spiritual theme song. It's ascension time, baby. It's ascension time. Do the things you love to do that bring you joy. Do it. See how life changes for you. I want to break free. I want to break free. God knows I want to break free. So before I pour my first pour of paint, I always like to drill holes in the rim of the paint. So that way you don't waste a lot of paint. It doesn't get all crudded up on the top, because I have had to throw away so many cans of paint that just did not seal properly and then just got hard over time. And it just kept getting more gunked up. I learned my lesson the hard way. I don't want to waste. I don't want to put a bunch of stuff in the landfill. So what I like to do now is just get I can't remember what size bit it was, but just get a drill, drill a couple holes. I put about 9 holes in the top of this. And once you pour, you can just go around the rim and it all goes back inside and that rim stays nice and clean and you can properly seal it and use it again on a rainy day that you just feel like painting. So that's my tip of the day for paint. If you want to reuse it, which if you like the color, reuse it. I like to reuse as much as possible. And I love this color, so I definitely want to use this color again. Got 1, 2, 3, 4 girls. I wonder sometimes, I wonder if I was wrong. I guess I'm better than something else. That is the paint on the wall. We're gonna let it dry, and while it's drying, we're gonna clean out all of our brushes and our trays and save as much of this paint as we can, because it's money-infused paint. Would you wanna throw away money? I don't wanna throw away money. So, I'm gonna be cleaning off the brushes that we put in our bucket. I wanna just make sure I get all that back into the container. Have you ever blessed your paint before? Have you ever thought about blessing your paint or putting in some oils and infusing it with energy that you wanted to put in? If so, leave a comment below. I'd love to hear about it. How do you feel afterwards? What oils did you use? What was your experience like? Share. Sharing is caring. The more people that see that this can be the case and you can do it, the more people will want to try it. So yeah, I would love to find out what you've done. Oh, and I need to stretch my back. I don't know if I told you guys this. I know I did, but a while ago I had some pinched nerves in my back when a scaffold fell on my head. It pressed my neck in. So being in one position for a while starts agitating it just a little bit. If I'm at my computer too long, I just need to like give it a nice stretch and crack. And yeah, it feels so much better than it was feeling just a couple months ago. I went to so many chiropractors and masseuses and acupuncture and everything. And it wasn't really until I went to this one girl that was an acupuncturist, but also an energy worker, which I don't even know if she knows that she is. I think just naturally comes to her. But it wasn't until I went to her that a lot of the emotional energy that was tied into it got worked out of my body. Because as much pain, energy manifests in your body. So when you're having pains in your body, there's very strong chance that some of that is emotional pains. Because you have different bodies, your emotional body, your etheric body, your physical body. And so when you're feeling pain, sometimes it's a manifestation of something else going on. When I went to her, I told her all the things that were happening, and it was, you know, kind of with the whole corona and the living with mother-in-law and not really working a lot, all the things. It was just all the things that I wasn't even really aware of until it was able to come up to the surface and I was able to express it. Then I just surrendered. I surrendered to God everything that needed to be surrendered. And as I was doing that, I could feel it melting away. And it's been so much better ever since. Because I released a lot of that stuff that was just emotional energy tied into my body. If you don't know a lot about energy manifesting in your body, then Carolyn Mace has a handful of really good books, but I would look her up. She's on YouTube, Carolyn Mace, and she does a lot of the a lot of seminars and all this other stuff, but she's got some really great information about that. And so sometimes, you know, you get hurt a little bit and it starts building up, but that doesn't all have to be just physical pain. That's also old trauma that gets stuck into your body and all the things. So now, since that's happened, one thing I've really learned and messages that I've gotten from my guides is be more kind to your body. This is, you know, this is my vessel that I'm in. I want to take care of my body. And so I've learned to balance a lot more. I don't overwork myself and put too much strain on my body when I don't need to do that. If I can ask for help, I ask for help. And then I don't need to be all things to all people. I just be myself, and that is good. Go play with my dog, go play with my fiance, go play with his son, and just find balance, get outside and ground myself, take off my shoes, and just feel the earth. And do something that I love to do. And I love to do a lot of things. I just got a Cricut machine. Life is good. Life is good. It's like a world of possibilities when you get a Cricut maker for some reason. Well, I got the Cricut maker, but there's a lot of different kinds. Well, there's three different kinds, I think. I had a Silhouette before. But as much as possible, do something creative. Take it easy on your body. Love your body up. Protect your knees. Protect your skin. My dad tried to tell me that a while ago. I have rougher hands now because I wasn't really wearing gloves a lot on any project that I was working on. I still typically don't. But, you know, like, take care of your skin. Take care of your body. Take care of yourself. Infuse your paint with loving energy, whatever you want to feel. It's a world of difference. I feel a world of difference. So that's my advice. That's my advice for the day. You are building and hanging with Sarah, and this is just what happens when you build and hang with Sarah. You get a lot of random information and things that's going on. I was saying yesterday that my dad, when I would work with him, he would spend hours, I would be doing whatever project, and he would spend the entire time telling me stories about his life and his childhood and just stories. He was such a great storyteller. And he just passed away in December. And I was crying this morning because I missed him. I went to the hardware store and I thought about him. And I just thought, you know, I need to meet this person at the hardware store because I'm going to be going in here quite often, and I want to get to know the people that work in the places that I go to. And my dad would know everybody, it seems, at Home Depot. So, you know, as a child, I was like, let's get out of here. And now I'm like, I like knowing people at Home Depot. I like knowing people at hardware stores. It's just always good. I push this lid down. And because I drilled the holes in the paint can beforehand, this lid just closes so easily, and I have so much extra paint. The paint is only up to here, so I'm not wasting any of this paint. I want to keep some of this paint and reuse it for future projects. And it's already got the money juju in there, so I don't want to throw away money. Nice, good seal. Nothing's coming out of there. I'm going to go and clean off this little water and some soap because it's a water-based paint. And we can just clean it off with some water and soap. And then we'll be able to use our paintbrush again. I've thrown away multiple paintbrushes in the past, forgetting to clean them out. They just get hard, they get nasty. And when you want to do a project and you're in that mood and you're ready to go, and then all of your paintbrushes are hard as rock. And now I gotta go to the store and get a new paintbrush, which I wasn't in the mood for. I didn't really want to put on some shoes or underwear or whatever. And now I got to do that because I didn't clean out my brush. So I like to clean out my brushes. Clean out your brushes. You take care of your tools. Your tools take care of you. And you save some money that way. I still think that this is a good option, to do, because if he ever does want to take down the shelves, it's going to be easy for him to just take off that tape and take off the brackets. And instead of patching it up forever, and it makes it harder for him to get to the screws, that could be, you know, a little bit of a pain in the butt. So I want to make it as easy as possible. And I'm also used to helping a lot of renters out with being able to take stuff away and still get your deposit back. So as much as possible, I like to try to make it easy for removal if you ever want to change it, because feelings change, seasons change, energy changes, emotions change, and you just want to change sometimes. So we don't need it to be permanently up on the wall, and this is a good solution by using painter's tape. Who knew? I'm still not 100% sold on it, but I'm a lot closer than I was yesterday with the idea of, okay, well, this is something new and I haven't tried it before. And I'm glad I did, because like I said before, if you don't try, how will you know? And I'd rather just try things and see how they work. And I'm here at the space. If something needs to change, I can quickly change it. Hopefully, I should knock on wood. But if something needs to change, I can change it. And we're just gonna go from here. I'm gonna let the paint dry. Thank you for joining me. I'm Sarah James. This is Abundant Possibilities. If you wanna see any of my projects, you can go on to my website, sarahjames.tv. And I'll put a link down there. And I'm having so much fun building and hanging with you guys. I hope you subscribe to the YouTube channel. I'm gonna be posting a lot more videos, because that has been my intention. And darn it, it's happening. It's happening. I'm gonna be posting more videos of my projects that I'm working on. So hope you subscribe and hang out and see how this project goes. We're just on the beginning phases, so there's a lot more to come in this project, and we're gonna be moving on to a music room after this one. So hit subscribe. Make sure that if you have an experience with blessing your paint or doing any kind of energy work on paint and the workspace that you're in, leave a comment below. If you want to know more about the essential oils that you can use, then send me a message and I'll get back to you when I see it. Yeah, because I love you guys. I know who you are. I know what you are. I know how you serve. Thank you, thank you, thank you for joining me. And I will see you guys again soon. Yeah.